another exciting episode of Kicking It, Gavin Chooch.
I am Gab.
And I am Chooch.
And we are back. Another exciting weekend. We'll take a look at the results this week, or this past weekend, and then we have Boxing Day matches just about ready, set to go. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday games this week, and we got more to follow. So we're going to start off with our recap. We had Saturday games. Kick right off with those. Take it away, Chooch.
It's the most wonderful time of the year, guys. We had the weekend games. Now we have the weekday games. Let's get it started with some absolute banger of games. We start off with Friday. We had Brighton, Southampton, a nice 1-1 draw. I know, good result for Southampton. Brighton, on the other hand, not the best. I know Cameron Archer did have a goal ruled offside near the end. That could have been the winner.
Yeah, a couple good ones. Southampton did play really, really well. Like the way the jerseys looked, even though I said they were hideous before. But yeah, it's a good result for Southampton for sure.
Definitely. That was just the lone Friday game. We move on to Saturday, Super Saturday, and start off Brentford-Leicester, 4-1 to Brentford, hat trick by Shade.
Yeah, I think I thought Leicester might have had the chance to win this one. They did play really, really well. Jamie Vardy had a really good assist. But yeah, here we go with the hat trick for Shade, and Jan Wissa gets the other goal. Shade also did provide the assist on that goal as well in the man of the match performance.
Yeah, absolute baller. Just really strong from Brentford. Leicester was really strong those opening 21st minutes. They got the goal, and then after that, it was just complete different ball game. Brentford dominating. I think it was Shade's first goal in like over a year or so.
Interesting.
And he gets a hat trick.
Yeah, definitely a good performance by him.
Yeah. We move on. Palace, Newcastle. 1-1 draw. Gehi with an own goal in 53rd. And then Munoz with the late equalizer, 94th minute, after he had a couple chances early in the game to bury it. Bury some chances, and he didn't, but he comes in clutch late to save them.
Yeah, definitely a good result for Palace, I'd say, here. Newcastle been playing really, really well the past few weeks, but just haven't gotten the result that they've been looking for. Still definitely, you know, wanting to see a little bit more Callum Wilson. He's been implemented with some more time as of recent. Alexander Isak came off really, really early. He had some injury concerns. Yeah. So we'll see what happens with him. Only got about 15, 20 minutes of game time before coming off. But either way, we'll see what happens. Harvey Barnes, obvious replacement outside of Callum Wilson. But we should see a start for Callum Wilson upcoming during the week, unless they opt to go with some sort of other different option. Miguel Almiron, maybe, with Joelinton at striker. We've seen it before. You know, Joelinton just willing about to play anywhere, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Anyways, we move on. Forest, Ipswich, very quiet game. Chris Wood breaks the deadlock in the 49th minute with the pen. And other than that, it was just, I would say, it was pretty evened. It was pretty evened out aside from that. Both teams had good chances, good amount of possession from both sides. Just that was only the goal of the game.
Hudson-Odoi with a lot of opportunities in this one. No real end result. Alanga did get just a little bit of time there, only about 15, 20 minutes. Ward-Prowse, no appearance here. Quite a bit of a shocker for me, for sure. Chris Wood gets the obvious pen take. Could have easily been Awoniyi, depending on what had happened there. But I just think definitely rotating the squad here a bit. Some maybe questionable for me. They got the result they wanted, but starting a 1-1 last weekend against Arsenal was the big shocker for me. And then Jota Silva, someone who seems like a super sub as of late, gets the start as well. Forest not going through their best of runs, but they don't have too much competition at this very second. But they do face Man City up next, so we'll see.
Yeah. Next up, we had Wolves Bournemouth. This one was an insane game. Bournemouth win 4-2. Larsson with the brace. Kluivert, I believe, did he have a hat-trick of pens?
Yeah, hat-trick of pens. The first ever Premier League hat-trick on penalties in the history of the league.
Disgusting.
I mean, we'll take it. We'll take it. And Milos Kerkez gets the other goal for me.
That was a nice goal about Kerkez.
He's unbelievable. He's someone I could see moving to a bigger club lately. And for Wolves, Strand Larsson, I mean, guy's an absolute beast. For me, I think just doesn't always get away with the result, and he did get two himself.
Yeah, but other than that, both teams played really well. Besides from Wolves just giving away three pens. Disgusting. Kirky's goal was really nice. The ball by Tavernier was nice, and then just smashed it.
Yeah, definitely man of the match performance from Kluivert because of the pens there. but I've always said Marcus Tavernier probably the most important player on the squad for me, as well as Kirky's.
Yeah. We move on to West Ham Arsenal. Our last game of Saturday, a 7-goal thriller all in the first half. Absolutely insane.
Yeah, definitely. Had a bit of promise for sure.
Yeah.
Going up 3-2 or going up 3-0, I believe it was. And then two back-to-back from West Ham. Absolutely unreal stunner. Free kick from Emerson.
Emerson, banger.
Juan Moussaka had a really good goal, but... all of Arsenal's goals pretty mediocre for me. A couple pens here, a couple pens there. Nothing too insane. But definitely, I mean, West Ham, they showed a little bit of resilience there. Truly unfortunate to concede on a pen, which was a little bit soft, I would say. But either way, Arsenal get the win. They continue to do what they do.
Yeah. Good result for Arsenal. We move on to Super Sunday. We had early games. We had three super early games. First up, we had Chelsea Villa. What'd I say, buddy? Nice 3-0 victory for Chelsea. Nico Jackson, Enzo Fernandez, and Cole Palmer. Fernandez balling out. All he had to do was leave his wife. We were saying it.
Yeah. Quite insane for sure. Nico Jackson, who's been on quite a heater himself. Very, very undershadowed, I'd say. Not too many people talking about him. But he has managed to put a couple of goals away very, very early to put Chelsea up. Enzo Fernandez, like you said, absolutely balling out. Cole Palmer, probably my banger of the week on that goal there.
Chelsea.
But yeah, Chelsea are playing well. I'd probably... chalk this one to, I wouldn't say this was a dominant performance for me, but I would say that Aston Villa haven't really had the great of a run as they've been having, kind of in a slump right now, not really getting anything from John Duran or Ollie Watkins, it feels like. In the beginning of the season, it was quite one or the other, turning things around for either side, so. Not exactly sure. You know, we're not seeing a lot of Tyrone Mings as well. He is just returning from injury, but still, he did get a little bit of a run unused in this one. And then Morgan Rodgers has been quite quiet as well.
Yeah. Emiliano Martinez had a really bad game. A lot of errors that Chelsea was unlucky to capitalize. Bad passes, and he did end up getting injured. So we saw Olsen come in the second half.
Yeah, replacement there at halftime. But either way, I mean, yeah, definitely interesting one for me. Villa just lackluster right now, but Villa Jean either has been quite well for me. You know, not really doing too much. I'd like to see Leon Bailey back in the starting lineup. Maybe throw Ross Barkley in there to start it off as well. I don't know. Something's got to change a little bit. They're going through a skid, but they usually run through a skid anyway most seasons.
They'll find a way to bounce back. We move on to United Everton. 4-0 win for Man United. Rashford and Xerxes both with a brace each. Amad Diallo balled out, I will admit.
Yeah, definitely. I thought a couple of the goals, you know, he did get two assists, but definitely key build up. Xerxes' goals almost tap-ins. Rashford scoring a couple tap-ins as of late as well. But Man United have been playing well. It's not one that we necessarily, you know, expected them to lose. I think I did say they would lose, but regardless, I mean, most supporters, most everyone figure Man United should have this one, no problem. I did also see a little skit that the new manager sounds like Gru. Sounds like Gru from Despicable Me. I'm going to have to watch the YouTube video for myself because the edit probably was a little bit edited, but either way, I'm going to have to check it out.
Yeah, but yeah, strong, comfortable win for United. We move on to Tottenham Fulham, 1-1 draw. Brennan Johnson once again with another goal. Tom Kearney, reckless red card. And he also got the assist. Or not the assist, the goal. The equalizer.
Yeah, it was a banger for sure. One of my bangers of the week as well. Brennan Johnson's was really good volley as well. Timo Werner, nice pick out there. But definitely the Tom Kearney, I mean, comes on, seems to almost be a hero, and then gets a red. You know, good luck on them. They managed to get out with the draw, which was pretty fair. But yeah, either way, Tom Kearney, I mean, deserves maybe some more playing time after that. Haven't seen him too much, but we'll see what happens. Fulham. Yeah. I mean, they're up and down. I'd like to say they're still somewhere in the middle right now. But definitely, you know, good run should be coming here pretty soon. Adama Traore unused this game.
Yeah, that's what Raheem Mendes was a bit quiet that game. Luis Nielsen did well. Wobi did well. Smith-Rowe a little quiet as well. But yeah, pretty good from Fulham despite the red card, so I feel like they'd be happy with the result. Under the hand, Tottenham, not so happy.
Definitely.
And we move on to our match of the week. Just a complete, utter dominance from Liverpool this game. 2-0 victory. Should have been more. Van Dijk alone should have had a hat trick.
I wouldn't necessarily say complete and utter dominance. I would say in the first half, they definitely came out dominating, controlling just about all the possession to start. We did end up dominating the possession in the totality of the game, but definitely did not take, you know, the few chances I would say we had. I believe we only had two shots on target. Very, very, you know, tough defense regardless. Very slim opportunities. Haaland had a couple in a lot of traffic. I think he probably had both shots on target that were in quite a bit of traffic, got blocked. But definitely some positives to take away for me. We played quite well despite the scoreline than we have been playing in the past few weeks. So I definitely saw positives to this. You know, everyone's still ragging, of course. Why not? But, you know, at the end of the day, we take it out to the next game. We got Nottingham Forest, and we'll see what happens there. But I like the positivity so far. Moving on, moving forward. Team's not completely out of it. I would say, though, that
there was one positive thing about the game, if we're being honest.
What
That
would you
was
say?
Jeremy Doku just balling out. He just coming back from injury, brought out the new look, the
The
headband.
headband.
Man thinks he's Matt Dweke.
Crazy.
But
Nah.
yeah, he was really well, absolutely cooked Trent. Cooked him so bad they had to sub him off.
Yeah. There Pep said that he's probably gonna go with Jack Grealish in the middle areas, in the future just to see what they could do. I don't know if that means he's gonna start him or bring him on, 70th minute to change things up. But I think we need to see something that we haven't seen. Couple players. It's almost like they're playing like they don't. There's no. Well, I mean, there is no urgency
There's
because,
no pushing.
yeah, almost. And I mean, it's hard to explain because I mean, yeah, I feel like if you win so much, the desire is less there. As much as we hate to say that as fans, that's probably some truth to it. But you see players like De Bruyne even, Foden even, top tier players who just feel like they're not giving it everything they got, or not using the best of their abilities when they know what the best of their abilities are. We saw Phil Foden all season last season, getting up in his right spot, taking a good shot, scoring a lot of bangers. If you watch him play, he's not even trying to get in that spot. Like nothing about it. And it could be all manager tactics, who knows? But you think as a player at some point when you're losing too much, at some point you gotta trust your own ambition. Same with De Bruyne. I've been really disappointed in what he's been putting out lately. Very big half winger type of midfielder as well. That's where I feel like he suits best. And he hasn't really gotten the chance to link up with Haaland either, which is where a lot of the offense, comes from at times.
Your bread and butter.
Yeah, literally. Yeah, dominated by Liverpool in terms of scoreline, but not the result that I was expecting. I was expecting a lot more difficult, a lot more of a bashing, but I do like the way we played at most times. We move on.
Move on to
The weekday matches.
weekday matchups. Yeah, we got some good ones. Let's kick it away right away. Let's go. Tomorrow we got Ipswich, Crystal Palace at Portman Road. Should be, I see a comfortable win here for Palace, I think. Nketiah didn't start last game, came on kind of late. I think this is a perfect game for him to start.
Interesting. I'm liking Ipswich for this one. I think Ipswich have played well in the past few weeks. I just think they've been a little bit unlucky. They've had a lot of moments of brilliance from Liam Delap. Crystal Palace have also played decently well as well. But I'm not sure. Something about Ipswich, for me, I can't help but root for them. Palace, I always root for to some extent as well, but always love the promotion story where they stay in the league and then end up there for years or have a good stint. But definitely, I'm going for Ipswich in this one. I like a 2-1 win.
Going 2-0 win Palace here.
There we go.
We move on to Leicester, West Ham at the King Power Stadium. Should be, I think, yeah, Van Nistelrooy will manage this game. So I'm expecting a huge new manager bounce. I'm going a 2-1 win for Leicester here.
Interesting, interesting. I usually always do take Leicester in these sort of unknowns. Definitely Ruud van Nistelrooy. I think it'll be good. I mean, the guys had maybe two trainings to this point, and they probably were recovery training and one maybe full training. So I wouldn't go as far as to say this is the new manager bounce yet. I'm going to go West Ham easy on this one, 3-1. But I do like Leicester coming up for the next couple of weeks here. I think that it'll favor them. I liked what, like I said, what Benishray did with Man United, you know, in the short time he had with them, kind of gave them a little bit of a purpose, and it's, you know, transformed to their new manager as well. But I'm going to go in West Ham here, 3-1.
We move on to Wednesday games. We've got a couple of Wednesday games, majority of our games. Kickoff first, Everton Wolves at Goodison Park. This game has goal fest written all over it, but my head's telling me 1-1 draw.
I like Wolves for this one. I like it. 3-2 maybe. I'm going to go goal fest as well. Everton do have quite a good defense. But I think Wolves, sometimes they turn it on, sometimes they don't. They should win this one. Who knows, though? They probably won't.
Yeah.
I'm going 3-2, like I said.
Yeah. I want to say goal fest, but my mind's telling me 1-1, so I'm going with the 1-1 draw here.
Yeah.
Next up, we got City versus Forest at the Empty Had.
Crazy. Definitely. I mean, expect a full force win for me.
Yeah.
The only thing I feel like this would be the perfect game. We do what we did Champions League. We go up, but it would be defending the lead at that point. We have to find out. We got to find ourselves in these small games. Not small per se, but the smaller clubs that we're playing, which Forest are actually a massive club. But, you know, the less competition, Forest still very, very good this season. They do things a lot of things well. But I definitely think this is one we should win very easily, very comfortably. And I'd like us to, you know, maintain a good lead throughout. But I do probably expect Forest to put at least the one away very, very early. Probably I'm going to go 3-1. City.
I was also going to say 3-1. Definitely see a Chris Wood good goal getting thrown in there, but I do think...
Hey, Chris Wood's a Man City fan. Grown up.
So, I do expect City to finally pull away, get a win.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, hopefully we'll see Oscar Bob posted back in the... not the training ground, but back in the training facility. So probably doing some minor stuff in terms of either conditioning or just getting back around the team, feeling it out. You know, he should be back for January, February time. So that's good. Kovacic at least out probably another month. Truly unfortunate because he is our quote-unquote probably Rodri replacement as close as we could get to him. And we've been missing him very, very big time.
Just recall Calvin Phillips, buddy.
Wouldn't be surprised. He actually played really well at center back in the preseason.
Yeah. We'll move on to Newcastle, Liverpool at St. James Park. Should be a good game. I think it should be a good game, but I have Liverpool dominance written all over, I'm thinking.
Yeah, I'm probably expecting a Liverpool win here. I would like to see some points taken off for sure. Maybe a draw. Don't think Newcastle will necessarily have it in them.
Especially if Isak's gone.
Yeah, and just the trouble. I mean, I've been watching them play the last couple of weeks. They played really well, but just not able to get the result. Not able to get the goals. Against Liverpool. You're not going to have many chances regardless, and you got to take them for sure. But who knows? Callum Wilson could reintroduce himself to this Newcastle squad and earn us the starting spot.
Yeah. We'll see. But, yeah, definitely a comfortable Liverpool win. We move on. Southampton-Chelsea at St. Mary's Stadium.
Should be a battery.
4-0.
I think maybe like 2-3-0, maybe 2-3-1. But yeah, it should be a comfortable Chelsea win. Southampton, you never know what Chelsea you're going to get still to this day. You're either going to get the Chelsea that's very quiet, puts away a goal or two, or you're going to get the Chelsea that puts six. So, never know.
Yeah, should be. This is, I think this should, this has beating Chelsea written all over it, I think. Because, you know, a lot of the beating players that aren't playing in the Prem, this could be a good game for them. Maybe we'll see Mudryk out there. Maybe João Félix and Nkunku might get a start. Fofana, slight pickup of an injury. They said it's nothing to be worried about. So, but I think they're not going to risk it, especially with Tottenham on the weekend. So I'm thinking maybe we'll see Badiashile.
Yeah, place for him. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go, like I said, 2 or 3-1 on this one, Chelsea.
I like it. We move on to, on paper, looks like will be match of the week. We have Arsenal, Man United, at the Emirates. This game has 3-2 win to Arsenal.
I'm actually going to say something a little crazy. I'm going to go United win. I think the new manager boost, cooped with the ignorance that Arsenal have right now, the arrogance, all of it. I like Man United for this one. I like 2-1 win in an absolute banger of a game, hopefully.
I think it'll be close, but I do think Arsenal will pull away with it. They're going to score their easy goals on the freaking set pieces.
Yeah, we'll see.
But, I don't know. I'll definitely, you know, if Diallo has it in him to recreate what he did last week, but I don't think so, especially against this Arsenal team.
Yeah, definitely. I think that the yellow card reset is coming up pretty soon, I think. But there are quite a few players up close to it. I think there's quite a few Manchester United players, though. Let me see. Maybe not. Oh, Kobbie Mainoo, he's going to be suspended for match week 15, and so is, I'm sorry, for match week 14, and so is Lisandro Martinez.
Huge.
Yeah, so two big names for them out from the Arsenal match. No one out for Arsenal in terms of bans, but yeah, definitely a big one.
Yeah. We move on to the last ones again. We have Villa Brentford at Villa Park.
I like Villa for this one. I'm gonna go 4-2 Villa.
I think it'll be, you know, pretty close. I think Villa 2-1. You know, Brentford's still really good, but you know, I think Villa need to definitely bounce back after, you know, that game against, they've just been on a really bad streak. Lost Chelsea, back-to-back draws against Juve and then Palace, and then obviously lost to Club Brugge in the Champions League.
Yeah, tough for sure. I'm still going Villa. At Villa Park, just making sense to me. Game to bounce back in. Yeah, it's got to be Villa for me.
Yeah, that wraps up Wednesday's games. We move on to Thursday. We have Fulham Brighton at Craven Cottage. I think this is like one of my sleeper games. I'm pulling with a Fulham 2-1 win. Should be very close. Hopefully we see some Adama Traore, even though, you know, unused sub last match.
Yeah, I like this one as well. I'm going to go, this being an absolute banger probably, I'm going to go 4-3 win Fulham And yeah, I like Fulham for this one at home. Definitely, I'm going Fulham.
Like Matoma been coming back, so should be a good threat for them.
Definitely.
And our last midweek game, we have Bournemouth, Tottenham at Vitality Stadium.
I'm gonna go for Tottenham on this one. I know there's a bit goalkeeper controversy going on a little bit for Tottenham. They just drew against Fulham, but I still like them. I still think that they have all the talent in the world. Just gotta put it all together once again, but they should be good enough to beat this Bournemouth side.
I think they're I think Forster's gonna have a stinker of a game, and then they're gonna realize, okay, maybe we need to sign a keeper. I think this is a game for it. Going Bournemouth 2-1 win.
2-1 Bournemouth. Interesting. Let's see. I think that wraps up the weekday games, and then we will be back for another episode on Friday.
And guess what?
And
More Prem, buddy.
yeah, literally. So we will continue this for sure. I think there's no Friday game. It should be a Saturday and Sunday slates. Yeah, Saturday,
Monday
Sunday
game.
slates. Oh, and a Monday
Monday.
game. Yes. Late Monday game. But yeah, still tough turnaround for some of these teams. Wednesday, Arsenal play. They play again on Saturday. Oh, no, they play Sunday. Okay. All right, that's good. But Man United play Saturday against Forest, who both play Wednesday. So that's going to be a very tough turnaround as well. Looks like, well, Forest actually get to stay in Manchester, so that's pretty good. But Manchester will also be traveling from London back to Manchester. Should be a very, very short flight, though, so that's good for them. But yeah, exciting times up ahead. We'll see what Man City could do to turn it around. We'll see if Liverpool could keep going and if anyone is willing to join them in the actual race. I know that Man City are down bad in the standings, fifth, but realistically,
Anything could happen.
I mean, we've seen 11 points is quite crazy. But I think the most we've seen before was 9 points. Let me look that up to confirm. Most points. Let's see if I can pull this up. All right, biggest lead to be overturned in a Premier League race. Manchester United did it in the 90s a couple times. 13. So 13 points I see from Arsenal in 97. United did it in 2003 at 10 points. And then City were probably the last few to do it with 9 and 10 points. So very doable, I'd say, but very, very unlikely. It would take something special and probably a last day of the season, unbelievable run.
All it takes is, one injury that just affects the whole team, goes down. Hopefully it doesn't happen, but sometimes that's what happens.
I was reading this article and it says, "Can Man City do it again?" And it says, "I think it's very much too early to be writing an article like this." That's
Well, here it
funny.
is anyway.
Yeah. About a quarter of the way through the season so far. Still a lot of time to go for sure, but still, I mean, it is possible that matches like these are massive for the club. I don't think Arsenal, or I'm sorry, I don't think Liverpool and City play each other again for the rest of the season. So that will definitely be tough. Let me actually check real quick. I don't think we do. See, Liverpool. Okay, I lied. We play again in February. But Mo Salah did say it could be his last ever time if he does depart in the transfer window. So we'll see. But it looks like February matchup, it would be our last and final of the season against Liverpool.
Yeah, but I'm just looking, you know, just to look, and they end off the year with a pretty good slate of games, like West Ham, Leicester, Tottenham, Chelsea, Arsenal, Brighton, and then the last game against Palace. So there's plenty of opportunity to drop points for all teams. Still a bunch of competitions in the mix as well. So, you know, it's going to be what they prioritize as well.
Yeah, definitely we'll see. I mean, like we've joked around earlier and said that, you know, Liverpool could accidentally win a treble here in a season that, you know, probably Man City and Real Madrid were favored to maybe win the Champions League. Both teams are really, really struggling at the moment. Liverpool seem to have no struggle in sight at this time.
Yeah. Aren't slot ball came out of nowhere.
Yeah, definitely. The slot penitentiary, they're calling it. Got managers in there like crazy. But yeah, we'll see what happens. Exciting times coming up for sure. Hopefully we could bounce back. We'll see what happens.
Yeah. That's all we got. You know.
Yeah, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. That's all I got.
Yeah. You know. Holiday season is here, so time to get jolly, throw some snow.
Yeah, for real. All right, guys, you are kicking it with Gab
and Chooch.